This gives a visualization of what is happening in learning by recording cases. There is a new problem A, shown by the color here, and memory contains a large number of cases, again represented by the different colors here. So we retrieve the case B that is most similar to the new problem A. In this particular case, we're deciding by color. And whatever was the solution to B, we apply to the situation A. While this visualization is useful, it's still very abstract. Let's think in terms of some practical, everyday examples. So you get up in the morning and you want to go for a run. You put on your sneakers, you have to tie your shoelaces. Well, how do you tie your shoelaces? That's a new problem. But of course, you have tied shoelaces many, many times earlier. So you have a memory of tying shoelaces to different kind of shoes. That's all stored as cases in your memory. So as you start tying the shoelaces for the shoe today, you simply retrieve the closest matching case and apply it. None of us really thinks very hard in the morning about how exactly to tie shoelaces. If we were to do it, it would take us a very long time. So in learning by recording cases, memory directly supplies us with the answer. We don't have to think about it.
So another example of this that comes to mind is in programming. Oftentimes in programming, we deal with the same type of problem over and over again. So I might imagine I'm starting out a new program and I'm writing a program in Java. So I'm given a new problem of creating a new program in Java. All I'm going to do is look back at my memory of cases and retrieve another case of starting a new program in Java. And I'm going to apply the solution to that program directly to this one. In this case, it's going to be something like when I'm starting a new program in Java, last time I started with public static void main. I'm going to apply that solution directly to my new problem, and it works. The solution can just be transferred directly to the new problem without any kind of modification. Then later in developing that same program, I might hit, for example, a null pointer error. I'm going to use that null pointer error as a new problem and use it as a probe into my memory. I'm then going to retrieve a case of when I encountered a null pointer error in the most similar program I've worked on, and then that's going to give me a solution that I potentially can apply directly to my current problem. So for example, the solution to the last time I encountered that same error might be to run the program in debug mode and allow it to tell me exactly what variable is null at the time of execution.
That's a good example, David. And we could even try to generalize it to medical diagnosis. Imagine that you went to a medical doctor with a set of signs and symptoms. So the doctor is faced with a new problem. What is the diagnosis for your signs and symptoms? The doctor may even have a number of cases recorded in her memory. These are the cases she has encountered during her experience. So the doctor may select the most similar case, the most closely resembling case, which in this case might be B, and say that I will apply to A exactly the same diagnosis that I applied to B. So a case, then, is an encapsulation of a past experience. And learning by recording cases is a very powerful method that works in a very large number of situations, ranging from tying your shoelaces to medical diagnosis.